Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a 2019 Dufour 460. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this vessel has.
Do a video review of the 2019 Dufour 460. Starting out the bow, you can see we have a really nice plum bow, stainless steel protector guard right there, so you don't have any mishaps with the anchor as you're pulling it up. Integrated bowsprit on it with the tack attachment point on that as well too. Facnor furling system, and all of the sheets obviously leading back aft into the cockpit. We'll look at it a little bit more in depth, but it has a self-tacking head cell along with Genoa tracks on the side deck. Outboard shrouds allow a nice easy walk access up to the foredeck. You can see there are three cleats on both starboard and port side, and side boarding access. We have a wood tow rail that's been recently varnished here. And again, a really nice aspect of being able to have all your sheets leading back to the helmsman. And we also have our block attachment point here for code zero or asymmetrical spinnaker. Dufour integrates davit systems that are retractable into the transom of the vessel. Nice large swim platform here, allowing you good access into the boat. We have a storage compartment, a life raft locker underneath there, and then underneath this centrally located components here is a wet bar. And so this is a nice little addition here. So we have a wet bar, and then on this side, we also have a refrigerator if so desired. But a really nice integration here with the davit systems. They're used on a lot of French manufacturers, and it's nice and convenient. Flagpole holder, we have access with the back, lifeline clips being able to open up. So you really open up this this area. Coming here into the cockpit, just down below us, we have lifting up support wedges. So when you're heeled over, you can get that additional support. Carbonite composite steering wheels. We have Plastimo compass. Our throttle location is inboard here. Right underneath that is our VHF ram mic. We have our windlass chain counter, engine display, bow thruster controls, and a multi-repeater right here that allows us to control the autopilot. And then again here you can control the chart plotter that's centrally located in the center cockpit table. At the port helm, we have our Fusion stereo controller, multi-repeater, access to our Lumar electric winches, and just a really nice overall feel, good access being able to enter the side decks. Large lazarette locker, both starboard and port side. And then as we make our way up to the side decks, you can see just a really nice wide side decks here, teak combing up on the cabin top. Large, this is a Lumar blocks, but on a Harkin Traveler here. And then again, all of the sheets leading back into the cockpit. Nice overhead flush hatches allow obviously a nice smooth look to it, but also a great light and ventilation. There's a forward sail locker that's here. And then just through the sail locker is our access to the anchor locker compartment itself. As I mentioned, the bowsprit is integrated into the hull of the vessel, giving a really nice clean finish look here, and a great spot to attach a code zero or asymmetrical. Looking back aft, you can see just how the self-tacker is set up, making it quite nice. This is a Z-spar mast, double spreaders, in mast furling, and just a nice overall feel. Nice Dodger with integrated handrails. There is a connector that goes from the Dodger to the Bimini itself. And again, here you can see the large cockpit that the Dufour 460 offers. Here at the cabin top, we have an electric winch off to the starboard side, manual off to the port. Again, all of our sheets and halyards led back here. And nice companionway doors that open up with ease, lock into position. And there are four gradual steps leading us down into the salon of the vessel.
Here we have a nice open salon feel. We have a nav station that actually has a couple different variations of movement. You can see from the tracks on the ground. The nav station will slide up forward. That seat will slide under the nav station, so you can have a forward or aft facing nav station. When it's in the aft position, you definitely gain more seating around the salon table here. Just above the nav station is our Fusion stereo, our generator control, ship to shore power switch, VHF. Here we have our electrical panel that allows us to turn on and off some of the major components. And again, really beautiful leather material. Integrated bench seat here that also acts as a handhold. Directly across from the nav station is our second head and shower compartment. This is a Japsco quiet flush toilet, access to the holding tank. Nice large window here with shades for privacy, but both seats, good European style, faucets. And again, just a overall nice feel, nice components being used here. Going aft of to one of two identical aft cabins, you can see we have queen size berths here. There is a nice window here with shade covering, overhead opening hatch, a side opening hatch, and a side port with aviation style shades. Hanging and storage lockers here, integrated bench seat that has also additional storage in it. One thing I really like is, you know, how Dufour does these just little touches here with the emblems, you know, at the door sills, just kind of making it stand out. But all one level here into the salon. And then again, going aft, we have the identical cabin on this side that's being used as storage for the cockpit cushions, fishing poles, and what have you. Moving up forward, again, with that forward galley, gives you a nice, big, wide feel. You have great headroom here in the salon. Lots of windows, overhead windows. I have all the shades, but I just wanted to give you that natural feel and look so you can see what it's about. Integrated handhold right here, which is quite nice. Lots of cabinetry throughout Bose speakers. And then we have the stove and oven. This is a 3-burner stove and oven. Here we have a top-loading freezer compartment. And then we have lots of storage around and then a fridge freezer compartment there. Integrated into this cabinet right here is optional pop-up television. This particular boat does have it. So the TV will pop up and actually pivot in a couple different directions for great viewing. But this gives you a nice feel for the open forward galley is what they call it. You know, accordion style countertops here. Nice cabinets with the latches. I like the built-in gas shocks here that allow the cabinets not to just kind of fall down into place. And again, really nice integrated handholds here. Moving up to the forward cabin, there is a small little step down here, but again, nice overall feel, just a big cabin, a squared off bed, which is kind of nice. Right behind the entry door here is your access to your toilet and sink. And then on the opposite side, they give you a separate shower, which is quite nice. A large full-length mirror, hanging locker to both starboard and port side, aviation style shades that open and close here, integrated bookshelves with little stainless steel kind of racks to keep things in, and again, just a great feel, good headroom carry throughout up here, and then walking into the master shower compartment. You can see here there is a bench seat that lifts up. This is a teak grate here where the shower sump is. Nice fixtures throughout, a plexiglass door that encompasses the shower. And again, really a nice, beautiful sinks, countertops, and again, additional storage down below and access to plumbing equipment. Storage underneath the bed as well. And also great accessibility throughout all the floorboards. This gives you a nice profile looking aft so you can see what the vessel looks like coming from forward to aft. And again, really nice feel. This couch right here definitely has some really neat options in it, which kind of lounge out. And again, this kind of opens up so you can get a nice feel. Great storage behind that. And yeah, anywhere you're kind of going throughout the vessel, you have nice storage. Hope you found this short video review of the 2019 Dufour 460 helpful and informative. If you're looking for a sailboat or a vessel like this, or have something that you're looking to put on the market, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. Thank you very much. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. And if you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this. Thank you again.